Hey everyone, and welcome to my first video for Train Sim World. Several people have been asking me over the last few months whether I'll be making any videos in Train Sim World, and so I guess that this video is finally my answer. In this video, I plan to drive the first scenario in the list of 8 scenarios which come with the game, which is a light loco move between Cumberland Yard and Hyndman. Upon arrival at Hyndman, I then need to reverse the locos and couple with several freight cars, at which point the scenario will end. The total distance travelled on this journey is around 17 miles. The first thing that I've really noticed, having been playing Train Sim World for a short while now, is really just what a vast graphical improvement this game is over the Railworks series. I've got all of the graphic settings on the Ultra setting to really get a sense of what the Unreal Engine can do with this game, but unfortunately the frame rate that I've been getting has been around 30 on average, which, whilst not terrible for a simulator game, I really do hope that future updates may be able to see this improve. With the PC that I've got at present, I'm often asked what the specifications are, and so I'm running this game in Ultra settings on a computer which is running an Intel Core i7 4790K processor with 16GB of RAM and an Nvidia GTX 980 graphics card. Looking at the route, which comes with Train Sim World at different times of day and with different weather settings, Unreal Engine 4 really does begin to shine as you notice all of the differences, from changing light levels to spectacular night lighting, from rain that makes everything truly wet to an intense blizzard. Couple this with the very high quality of the rendered locomotives, and I really do think that we're at the start of something quite spectacular with Train Sim World. There are still some small bugs that I've noticed that do need ironing out, but I really do think that there's a lot of new potential here. The train that I will be driving in this scenario is an EMD SD40-2 diesel electric locomotive. A total of 3,982 of these locos were built by General Motors Electromotive Division over an 18-year period between 1972 and 1989. Each locomotive weighs 184 tons or 167 metric tons and has a length of 68 feet 10 inches with a fuel capacity of up to 4,000 gallons. The prime mover is an EMD 16-645-E3 V16 turbocharged diesel engine, which drives a maximum power output of 3,000 horsepower. They have a maximum speed of 65 miles per hour, but on this journey today, the highest speed that we will be able to attain is 50 miles per hour. Now that I've introduced the game route and loco, and without further ado, let's begin the scenario. At the start of this scenario, the camera's now just going to pan down to put us into first person mode, and then I've got to wait for the supervisor to speak to me before I can continue with the scenario. Okay, so now I need to get into the locomotive, which I believe is this loco, so I've just walked up to it and pressed E to climb up these steps. Now I'm just going to walk up to the door here, click on that to open the door, and then come back and click on the door again to close it. And now I need to get into the driver's seat and press E to sit down.
Before we reach the end of the yard, I'll contact the dispatcher for permission to head out to Hyndman. Set the locomotive up and we'll get going when you're ready.
Okay, so I now need to set the locomotive up in a very specific order to pass the tasks in this scenario. The first thing I'm going to do now is turn on the headlights with the H key, and I need to press that 3 times to turn them to the fully brightest setting. So now the headlights are on the bright setting, and I need to press J and I to turn on the ditch lights and the instrument lights. And the next thing I now need to do is to put the reversing handle, which is just in front of us here, into the forward position with the W key. Now that I've done that, I need to set the automatic brake handle to the release position. So that's here. I'm just going to move that all the way to the release position now to pass that. And so the next task I've got to do is to sound the horn twice. And once I do that, my supervisor will then send a radio message. So I've got to wait for him to do that before I can proceed any further.
This is X551 requesting a track warrant from Cumberland Terminal to Hyndman. Over.
X551 subject to signal indications. Proceed from Cumberland Terminal as far as Cumberland Station. Wait there for eastbound Q116 to pass. Then proceed to Hyndman. Over.
X551, subject to signal indications, proceeding from Cumberland Terminal to Cumberland Station. Await passage of eastbound Q116, then proceed to Hyndman. Out.
So we've now got the radio clearance. I'm going to move the independent or locomotive brake into the release position, which I've now done. And you should now see the brake gauge on the left-hand side there. The red needle is now falling, which is the brake cylinder pressure gauge. So once that needle is pointing at zero, then the brakes are fully released. And now that I've done that, I can now use the throttle to start accelerating. And at this point, I'm now going to turn off the HUD, which was turned on just there. As for anybody who's watched my videos before, which I'm sure is most of you, you understand that I do drive in my videos without using the HUD for a more realistic experience. So I went straight into notch one of power there, which has brought us up to 10 miles per hour. Now the locomotive shouldn't accelerate any faster at this point. So what I'm going to now do is go up to notch two of power, just to bring our speed up towards 15. And now once we reach 15, I'm now going back to notch 1 to just allow our speed to fall off again. And then I'll go back up to notch 2 of power if we lose too much speed. So we're just driving through Cumberland Yard here, so that's why the speed limit is so low at 15 miles per hour, and will be for a fair distance yet. But just looking around here, you can just see some of the detail which has been put into this game. And I honestly think that the detail is quite stunning compared to what we've been used to. So I'll just look the other side now. And just looking over the cab controls as well, you can really see just how much detail there is there. Now let's get back to looking ahead. We've lost a bit of speed there, down to around 12 miles per hour. So I'm just increasing the throttle back up to notch 2 to bring us back up towards 15. And now we're doing around 15. I've gone back to notch 1 of power once again. This locomotive's throttle has 8 notches of power on it. And on this journey, I probably won't need to go above notch 5 to 6. I certainly do have to bear in mind I am driving a light locomotive. And as a result of that, with no load on the back, the train will accelerate an awful lot quicker than it would do normally. Just increase the power to bring us back up to 15 miles per hour, and now the power handle is back into notch 1 once again. What I'm looking out for along here now is an overbridge. After that overbridge, we'll come up on a second overbridge shortly afterwards, and we need to stop at Cumberland Station, which is just beyond that second overbridge. back up to notch 2 there, just to bring us back up towards 15 miles per hour, and you can now see the first of the two overbridges just coming up ahead. At this point, we are going uphill on a gradient of around 0.5%, which is causing us to lose just a little bit more speed than we would do normally. And it looks like the gradient may have shallowed just for a moment now, as we're not losing much speed at around 15 miles per hour. I can now see the second overbridge just coming up in the distance there. And so, as already mentioned, I do need to stop the locomotives just beyond that overbridge. And then I've got to wait for my supervisor once again to make a radio message to get clearance to proceed out onto the main line and head out towards Hyndman. Now losing quite a lot of speed due to the gradient, so the gradient certainly steepened just here. Just brought our speed back up to 15 and now I'm back down to notch 1, though we will probably start losing speed fairly quickly. I'm going to allow the train to get down to around 10 miles per hour just before the upcoming overbridge. And then I'll just apply the brakes lightly as needed to bring us to a gentle stop just after. I do have to try and stop in just the right place, or else I won't actually be able to complete this event in the scenario, and the radio message won't trigger, meaning that I won't be able to go any further. It looks like actually it's been marked ahead. It looks like I can just see the light blue marker there, which is indicating the stopping point where I need to stop the locomotives. I'm just allowing us to drop down to around 10 miles per hour now. I'm going to shut off the power in a moment. The power is now in idle, and I'm just about to make a minimal brake application, which I've just now done. And that should bring our speed down quite nicely to stop on this marker.
This is X551. We're ready to head to Hyndman. Over.
X551. Subject to signal indications. Proceed to Hyndman. Over.
X551. Subject to signal indications. Proceeding to Hyndman. Out.
So departing away from the station there at Cumberland Yard, the speed limit is still 15 miles per hour, so just in notch 2 here, just bring us up to 15. And now I've just dropped down to notch 1. We are still on the uphill gradient, so we are still losing a little bit of speed along here. Looks like there's a crossing coming up just ahead. I didn't see a whistle board for that. I'll just turn the bell on now, and I'm also going to sound the horn. So the horn sequence on routes in America, I believe, is long, long, short, and long. And you're supposed to hold the final long blast on the horn and keep that going until you're on or just over the crossing. One of the things that I do find is that I often miss the whistle boards or horn boards along American routes, so I do apologize if I miss any on this journey. And I also find that I often end up mistiming the horn, so I end up sounding it slightly too early or too late for a particular crossing. So again, I do apologize for any mistimings of the horn that I do on this journey today. Speed limit here is now going up to 25 miles per hour. However, it's quickly going to be dropping back down to 20 miles per hour, just at a point coming up in a moment where we're going to cross onto the far right-hand track. So I'm now going to accelerate up towards 20 miles per hour at this point, then I'm going to idle the power at 20 and allow the train to coast until we're clear of the junction. And then once we're clear of the junction, I should be able to accelerate up towards 25 miles per hour. I'm just going to apply minimal braking just for a moment, as we are actually on a downhill gradient of around 0.7%. I just want to ensure that I don't end up breaking the speed limit. The speed limit is now up towards 25 miles per hour, so I'm now going to put the power into notch 3, which should hold us at a speed of just below 25, around 23 to 24 miles per hour. At this point we're going up a gradient of 0.8%, which is keeping our speed down a little, though the gradient will be shallowing in a moment as we approach an area called the Narrows, at which point our supervisor then has a message for us.
This is the Cumberland Narrows. It's crazy that just the Wills Creek carved out. Lucky for us it did, though. Otherwise, it would have added another 10 miles to the line if we had to go around these hills via Crescent Town. Plenty of floods come through here in the fall. Strong enough to wash away road and rail. Although, things have improved over the years, right? Now the creek runs in a concrete box, but it still breaks free now and again.
Notch 3 of power is now comfortably holding us at around 23 miles per hour, and what I'm looking out for now is the next speed limit change, which is an increase in the speed limit to 35 miles per hour. The next video that I'm planning to be making after this video is actually on a German route, as I haven't covered any German routes for quite some time, and I'm hoping to drive a journey between Berlin and Leipzig, which is quite a long distance high speed journey, and I've quite enjoyed driving that, so I'm almost in the recording stage for that, and I'm hoping to record it just after the weekend. In addition to that, I am still of course planning on making the Marias Pass video, which is also forming part of a question and answer video. I've already got quite a few questions, but if there's any more questions that anyone would like to ask me for me to answer in that video, then please do ask me in the comments and I will add it to the list of questions that I've been collating. The speed limit here is now going up to 35 miles per hour, so I can accelerate towards that in a moment. At 35, I'm going to have to go between notches 4 and 5 of power to try and maintain the speed close to that. So notch 5 will bring us up to 35, then down to notch 4 until the train slows down a bit, probably to around 32 miles per hour. Then back up to notch 5 once again to bring our speed back up towards 35. At the 35 mile per hour speed board there, we were 2 miles away from the next speed change, which is an increase in the speed limit up to 50 miles per hour. In addition to the German video and the Marias Pass video, I'm also intending on covering a journey in the class 455 stroke 8, should I say, which I haven't yet covered on this channel, so I'm going to be doing that on the South London network. I'm also hopefully going to do a return journey on the Barnstaple to Exeter route, as I haven't covered that for a while, and I'm also looking into a freight journey that I can drive in the UK, as I haven't covered any UK freight in a while, and it's requested quite often by my viewers and subscribers for me to make more freight videos. So I'll probably do that in either a class 66 or a class 92. I'll see what scenarios are available or what scenarios I may be able to build for that video. One final video I'm also considering on doing very soon is a return journey between Newcastle and York using the class 91 enhancement pack. I notice we have a yellow signal just here, so I'm not quite sure what that's about. I believe it's got something to do with the speed limit along here, because I think there are speeds attached to American signals, but I'm not entirely sure what that speed limit would be. Unfortunately, with this game, I've looked in the manual and I've looked through the tutorials, and so far I haven't found a tutorial regarding the signals and what the different signal aspects mean on this route. The speed limit is now going up to 50 miles per hour, so I can accelerate towards that around now. I'm going to need to use notch 6 of power to maintain the speed around 50. We're now coming up at our next waypoint at Ellerslie, where we're going to get another message from the supervisor.
ahead, we'll pass through the town of Ellerslie. Not much of note, but this run up from the Narrows to Hyndman is our last chance to be sure about the train brakes before beginning the climb to Sandpatch Summit. Coming down can be just as treacherous. After the twists of Glencoe and Fairhope, you'll be glad to see straight at Hyndman. Don't get too comfy, though. Too much speed and the curve at Corriganville will have you in the dirt in no time.
As you can see here, notch 6 of power is perfectly holding the train at 50 miles per hour, and I won't need to reduce the power now until we get closer to our destination at Hyndland. So having now driven this particular scenario a couple of times, I can honestly say that this really is quite an entry-level scenario for those of you who maybe want to learn to drive without the HUD and get that more realistic experience, because primarily it's just about accelerating at the increasing speed limit points right up until you get to 50 miles per hour, and then you don't need to slow down until you get towards Hyndland. I notice we're still getting some yellow signals along here, but I'm not entirely sure why that is, as I know that all of these signals along here were clear on my first run on this journey. So I'm just going to continue to drive at the speed limit for now, and just hope that I'm doing the right thing. Coming up within the next couple of miles now is our next waypoint, which is at Cook Mills. Now coming up on the Cook Mills waypoint and awaiting another message from our supervisor.
You're running great so far. Keep it up.
We're now around 2 miles from the next waypoint, which is at Wills Creek. Along this section of track, we are continuing to traverse several small gradient changes, going slightly uphill or slightly downhill, but none of them are really affecting our speed at this point, and we haven't dropped below around 48 miles per hour at any point, as you may have noticed. So notch 6 really is the perfect setting to hold this loco at 50 miles per hour, though I don't know if that would be the case if you had a heavy load behind you. In fact, you may well need more power than that if you were pulling quite a heavy train. We're now coming up on the Wills Creek waypoint, and at that point we've then got around 3 miles to go to Hyndman, and of course we're now expecting another message from our supervisor.
You've no doubt noticed we share a lot of tracks out of Wills Creek over Sand Patch Creek. These hills don't leave much room for the railroad to squeeze past. We're now coming up on a yellow over green signal. Again, I'm not quite sure exactly what that's telling me to do. I do believe the aspect may be approach limited, though I'm not 100% certain. At this point, I'm just gonna slow down slightly, so I've just cut the power down to notch 5, and just to allow our speed to drop just a little bit. So at that signal there, we had 1 mile to go to Hyndman. And then at the next signal, we've got 1 mile to go to an upcoming 25 mile per hour speed limit. And then once we've entered the 25 zone, we should be then be getting closer to our stopping point near Hyndman. is X551 approaching Hyndman. Requesting permission to stop and run back into the siding at Hyndman. Over. X551, subject to signal indications, proceeding with stop and run back. How? We're passing through Hyndman. The siding should appear on the right-hand side shortly. It runs until just outside town. Stop beyond the switch and we'll run back into it and connect to the stop cars.
So just reduced the power there as we're coming up on the single yellow signal. Now coming up on a girder bridge, which we're going to be crossing. And at the girder bridge, we've then got around 800 yards to go to an upcoming 25 mile per hour speed limit. At this point, we're about to start going up a grade as steep as 1.5%, which is going to cause us to lose more speed. So I'm just leaving the power here in notch 4 to keep going at around 30 miles per hour until we need to slow down further. I've now reduced the power to notch 3 just to bring our speed down towards 25. The cars that we've got to connect to are now on our right hand side. We're just passing them here, and so we've got to drive up the track just beyond the point where the track on the right hand side joins this track, and I've got to stop just beyond there and then reverse into the siding to connect up to the trucks there. But before I do that, I've got to actually disembark from the loco and walk up to the point to manually change the switch. So I slowed down slightly too early there. We're now entering the 25 mile per hour speed zone at the two speed posts on the track on the right and left of us. You can now see the blue marker just ahead, which indicates the stopping point where I need to aim to stop to ensure that the whole train has cleared the point here, so I can then get out the train and change the switch. So I've now idled the power completely, which is allowing our speed to come down. I'm also just making a minimal brake application, try and ensure we do stop in the right place. I'm just going to release the brakes now momentarily, as we are down below 10 miles per hour towards 5. And now if I just allow the train to coast for a moment, hopefully we should be able to stop in just about the right place for turning around. So I've now put the brakes on here. And now that I've done that, I now need to disembark the loco and head to go and change the switch. So I'm going to press E just to get out of the driver's seat. Now I'm going to open the door behind me here by clicking on it. Let's just walk up. I'm just going to press F1 for a sec to turn the HUD on, as I actually find it easier to use the HUD when I'm walking around, just to help with the directions so I know where I'm going. You can press shift here to run if you'd like to, but I'm just going to walk, just to allow you to see the detail a bit better around here. So I walk up to the switch and I just click on that, and now you can see that the point has changed so that the locos will now be directed into the siding there. And again, just look at the detail on this point and on this track. It's a level of detail and level of fidelity which we're just really not used to, and I really am very impressed with the graphical quality in Train Sim World. So I now need to walk back to the locomotive, the one that I just got out of. Again, just to stop just before I walk back, just looking at the detail here on this locomotive. It really is quite stunning. Those textures really are superb. And I love the way that it just reflects, and you can see bits of dirt and texturing on there. It just really adds to the level of detail and immersion in the game. So I'm just walking back up here now. In fact, I'm going to go back and get on this rear part, because I see that's the door I came out of before. So now I've done that, let's just close the door here and get back into the driver's seat. And now what I need to do is go into reverse and start to accelerate. So I'm just going to turn off the HUD once again, and now I'm going to just completely release the brakes and put the reversing handle into the reverse position. Now, with the brakes fully released, due to the fact that we were previously on an uphill gradient of around 1.4%, the loco should now start to roll, and it should be able to roll up to speed. The speed limit is going to drop to 10 miles per hour just as we enter the siding here. If I just press the right hand arrow twice, you can actually now see on this side is how I'm going to have to drive, so I can see the trucks that we need to connect to. I'm just going to go back for a sec, just back to the driver's view, to keep an eye on the speed. And once we reach around 10 miles per hour, I'm then going to start using the independent locomotive brake to control our speed. You can see we've just crossed the point there, so the speed limit is now 10 miles per hour, and we've just reached 10. And I've just applied minimal locomotive braking to try and bring our speed down a little and ensure that we don't break the speed limit. Slow down there to around 5 miles per hour. Now just going to have a look outside to see if I could see the trucks coming up, and I still can't, so we're a little way off them yet. Let's get back into the driver's cab just so I can keep an eye on the speed. Just applying some locomotive brake again to try and ensure that we don't break the speed limit, as we are right on 10 miles per hour now. And now I need to look back outside and turn around again to see if we're getting any closer yet. Of course, we are getting closer, but should I say, to see if they're coming into view yet. And they're not quite, so just went the wrong button there. So just to get back into the cab, we are just on 10 miles per hour, and it looks like I'm holding nicely there at around 10. I'm just going to increase the locomotive braking very, very slightly to try and ensure that we don't break the speed limit. You can now see the freight cars coming up just ahead there. And so what I want to do is to slow right down to below 5 miles per hour before coupling. In fact, I really want to aim to couple at around 2 miles per hour. Just reducing the locomotive brake again, as I felt that we were slowing down slightly too much. Keep pressing the wrong arrow key there and going into the wrong view initially. So yep, we are back in the cab. We are slowing down now to around 5. But I am going to release the brakes just for a moment there, as we're probably slowing down slightly too early. Now I'm reapplying some locomotive brake again just to control our speed. You can now see that we're getting very close to the freight cars. Brought us too close to a stop there. Just want to check our speed. So we're now doing around 3 to 4 miles per hour. Just brought us right down, and now we've coupled up to the cars behind. So now I'm going to turn on the HUD so that I know what I'm doing here to turn the locomotive off again. So I've got to set the reverser to neutral, so I'm just going to press the W key now to put that into the neutral position. And I also need to set the brake handle to the full service position, so I'm going to move that right around. Now that's in the full service position, I need to turn off the lights, so I'm going to press I and then J, and then press Shift and H 3 times to turn the headlights off.
Good work. Before heading back, let's grab a bite to eat with the repair crew. That's them by the pickup truck.
And so now that I've done that, I've pretty much finished the scenario here. Just got to get out of the loco and close the door. and then walk up to just the fence by the pickup truck there, and then the scenario completes. So we've arrived at our destination now, and I really just wanted to say thank you very much for watching this video. I really do hope that you have enjoyed it. If you did, then please don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, please don't forget that for the latest channel updates, you can find me on Facebook, and the link to my Facebook page is in the description of this video. And in addition to that, also, if you'd like to sponsor anything towards my channel on Patreon, then please visit my Patreon page for more information. And the link for that is again in the description of this video. And so just here, I'm just taking another look outside the locomotive scene. I'm just going to turn the HUD off for a moment, just to show you again the fantastic detail that we've got here. And just walk along and look at that, and look at the detail on the bogey down here. It really is quite something, quite spectacular. And so let's just walk along now, go to the pickup truck, and scenario complete.